not only in the deep levels of the deep brain, the so-called unconscious fields. Speaker doesn't like to divide consciousness into the unconscious and conscious. It's all conscious. Compare that with those words, which consciousness is whole. You can divide it. Either for profit, for amusement, or for various other subjective reasons. But consciousness is whole. It's really indivisible. Don't be likely about break it up. So let's go into this question. What is the root of fear? Is it thought? Thought being the accumulated memories born of knowledge, experience, and thought born of knowledge, and knowledge being limited, so thought is limited. It is fear. Subjectively first, inwardly first, is that fear born of thought. Thinking about tomorrow. Thinking about what might happen. My once wife may run away. Thinking in terms of not the actual present, but in terms of the future or the past. Is that the cause of fear? So, if it is the cause of fear, what the speaker says is, and please don't accept it, then what will you do with thought? You understand the question? If I'm afraid of you, because you may not be in tomorrow, larger audience, smaller audience, if I'm frightened, I want to find out the cause of it. Have a large audience to make myself a very and so and I want to find out the origin of fear, how it comes. As we said the other day, I'm not, one is not analyzing, one is watching. One is perceptive, which requires sensitivity. Not a conclusion, not saying, I must get rid of it, I must do something about it, I must escape from it, and so on. But watching. To watch. Very clearly, without any direction, without any motive, to see, to find out for oneself if thought is the origin of this fear. Then I say to myself, what shall I do with thought if that is the cause of fear? How can I stop thought? You understand? I will find you here. Please come on.